What's going on, guys? Let's do this problem right here. The question is asking, determine whether the function f of x is equal to 2x cubed minus 3x plus 1 satisfy the conditions of the mean value theorem on the interval minus 2, 2. If so, find the points guaranteed to exceed by the theorem. So first of all, what is mean value theorem? Mean value theorem is saying that if f is continuous on the closed interval a, b, and differentiable on AB, then there's at least one point C in AB such that f of B is minus f of A over B minus A is equal to f prime C, right? So that's the condition. So let's see, first of all, is this continuous? If you see this equation, this is the domain of this is any real number. Therefore, this is continuous. Therefore, this satisfies the first condition, that is continuous. And the second condition is whether it is differentiable. To find whether it is differentiable, we have to find the first derivative and see whether it is continuous in all points. But we have to particularly, if we want to be continuous within this, the closed interval points. So let's see what happens. So if I take the derivative, f of x, f prime x, that's going to be equal to 6x square minus 3. And in this case, this is a parabola, so this is going to be a continuous in all real numbers. Therefore, this is differentiable. So this satisfies the second condition. Therefore, we can use the mean value theorem. So let's do the mean value theorem. So to do the mean value theorem, I had to equalize this f prime x to this equation f of b minus f of a over b minus a. So in this case, we have the two points given. This is my f of b, 2 is my f of b. So if I substitute this value in this equation, it's going to be 2 times 2 power 3 is going to be 8, 8 times 2 is going to be 16, 16 minus 3 times 2 is going to be 6, 16 minus 6 is going to be 10, 10 plus 1 is going to be 16, wait a minute. So 16 minus 6 is going to be 10, 10 plus 1 is going to be 11. 11. So 11 is my f of b. Then if I substitute minus 2, well, let's see what will I get. Minus 2 to the power 3 is going to be minus 8. Minus 8 power times 2 is going to be minus 16. Minus 16 minus 3 times minus 2 is going to be plus 6. So minus 16 plus 6 is going to be minus 10. Minus 10 plus 1 is going to be minus 9. So minus 9. And in the bottom, we are going to have 2 minus minus 2. 2 minus minus 2, that's going to be 4. Therefore, in the top, we have 2 over 4, which is equal to half. Then we can, now this is, we have found this value. Now here, we have to equate this one to this first derivative to find the x value. That's the question. The question is, not just the x value, we have to find the point. They are asking to find the point, so we have to find x and f of x. So let's see. So first of all, I equate this one to f prime x, so it's going to be 6x square minus 3 is equal to half. So if I equate this one, if I bring this 3 to the other side, it's going to become 6x square is equal to 3 plus half, therefore this is going to become 3.5. 3.5, then x square is going to be equal to 3.5 divided by 6, and x is going to be equal to 3.5 divided by 6, and we square this one. So this is my final value, and if I find the value for this one, I will get plus or minus 1.15. So this is my final value, and we have to check whether these two numbers are in this domain, in this closed interval. For first of all, if I check the plus 1.15, it's definitely in the between this interval, and negative 1.15, this also is within this interval. Therefore, we can take two of these values, and in this case, they are asking for the points. Since they are asking for the points, I have to find f of x for both of them. So first of all, f of x is going to be f of positive So this can be plus or minus, so positive 1.15. So if I substitute this value in this equation, I will get 0.62. And if I substitute negative 1.15 in this equation, I will get 1.38. Therefore, my final answer is going to be, when x is equal to 1.15, positive 1.15, the f of x is going to be, f of x is going to be 0.62. And when x is equal to negative 1.15, f of x is going to be 1.38. And these are the 20, these are the 2 points, and this is my final answer. I hope you guys like this video. See you next time.